staff and students, and welcome to our assembly for Term 4, Week 8. Before we begin, I would like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we stand today and recognise their continuing connection to land, water and culture. We pay our respects to the elders past, present and emerging. Please stand for the National Anthem. I would now like to announce the Student of the Week for Term 4, Week 7. Prep M, Suri, for always giving her best and working very hard. Prep N, Mason, for his use of adjectives to make his writing more interesting this week. Prep P, Lucas, for being a great friend to others and helping classmates in and outside the classroom. And Prep R, Michael, for making great choices and always putting 100% effort in his learning. Now for the Grade 1s. 1A, Advit, for his amazing writing about Pig the Pug and the evil scientist. 1B, Asma, for her fantastic detailed narrative about a shark. 1H, SJ, for helping other students in the class. And 1K, Sam, for being an excellent role model and supporting her peers in their learning.
From 2A, Mehan, for working hard despite his broken arm. From 2D, Narali, for her amazing effort when writing her narrative. From 2M, Jaden, for always trying his personal best. From 2P, Daniel, for being the best helper every day. From 2R, Jack, for doing great work on his narrative story. Now time for the grade 3s. From 3L, Isabel, for helping other students. From 3M, Madison, for making great text self-connections with her book. And from 3R, Abdullah, for settling into grade 3R for using excellent manners.
From 4A, Kashvi, for working hard to achieve her writing goals for supportive classmates. Regan, for being helpful and a caring friend and always giving her best effort with classwork. Kathleen, from 4R, Kathleen, for representing her classroom work to high standards. From 4V, Karat, for always listening both in the classroom and on the playground. Now for grade 5s. From 5B, Natalie, for exemplary manners and being a helpful classmate. From 5D, Tani, for all the great work she is doing since being back at school. Well done, Tani. From 5L, Finn, contributes during reading groups while learning about bushfire prevention. From 5S, Nita, for her excellent dictation to her work.
Now for the grade 6s. From 6G, Avinit, for sharing his deep insights with the class during novel study discussions.
From 6H, Aaliyah for working well in maths groups and sharing her knowledge with others. From 6S, Jamin for being a hard-working and self-motivated student. Well done, Jamin. And from 6W, Mahadissa for always being willing to help others and being such a great role model. And now I'll read out the special awards for week 7. Multimedia, Thomas and 3R for creating fantastic images on the iPad.
We'll now draw out the Mighty Merit winners for last week. It has been great to see so many entries coming in each day. So keep up the great work and remember to do the right thing, and maybe this week you could be nominated. The winners for week 7 are Anne Marie from 2N
and Ashton Marmick from 3L. Our magnificent cleaners continue to do their great job keeping the school clean and safe for all of us. Please remember that they do more these days because of COVID, so every little thing that you can do will help them out. The winners for week 7 are 1C, 2A, 3B, and 6G. Here is today's Yajidi.
Few assemblies, our house captains will be doing some videos to teach you a little bit about the great people our houses are named after. But before we wanted to see what students and teachers knew about Caroline Chisholm, here is a video we created to help you understand. We hope you enjoy it.
Teachers and students of Courtney Gardens. Today we'll be showing you an iMovie of Caroline Chisholm.
As you know, in Courtney Gardens there are four houses, each named after famous people in Australian history. Flynn, Melba, Bradman, and finally, Chisholm.
As a proud member of Chisholm, I love being part of a team that represents the house to the best of their ability by demonstrating the school values.
Now time for the interviews on who people think Caroline Chisholm is.
Caroline Chisholm was famous for, helping women to vote in Australia a long time ago, and she was also on the $5 note a long time ago.
I think Caroline Chisholm was a very important woman.
I think Caroline Chisholm is a woman who helped out families through the gold mines.
I don't know what she is. I think she was a politician.
I have no idea who she is, but if I was to guess, I would guess she is some type of sportswoman. I'm going to say runner.
I think Caroline Chisholm is a scientist.
I think Caroline Chisholm is a famous singer from the 1900s. Famous opera singer, yeah, pretty sure.
I think Caroline Chisholm is a woman who created ideas that help benefit society in Australia.
Oh, you'd think this would be an easy question given I teach this to the kids every single year. She was a social worker, someone who did a lot of great deeds for people, a very kind-hearted person. I think she helped out women in particular. Thank you.
I think she's a swimmer.
I think Caroline Chisholm is a figure skater.
I think Caroline Chisholm is my sister Zora.
I think Caroline Chisholm is an educator.
I think she was a queen.
I think that she is, let's see, I think she's either Labour or a Liberal politician, but I could be wrong.
I think she's a famous singer.
Caroline Chisholm was an Australian famous nurse in the First World War.
She was a humanitarian.
A humanitarian is a person who helps people in need, often helping to provide things like food, clothing and shelter. Caroline Jones Chisholm was born in England on 30th of May 1808. At an early age, her father William trained Caroline Chisholm and all his children to be responsible to others, and that made her want to help people when she grew up. On 27th, 1830, Caroline, then 22, married Archibald Chisholm, and in 1938, they moved over to Australia where they settled in New South Wales.
Chisholm became aware of the bad conditions that faced immigrants. She was very sad and worried for the young woman who came to Australia without any money, friends, or family or jobs to go to. Caroline Chisholm put these young women into shelters such as her own and helped them find a place to stay. She started an organization to begin an immigrant women's home shelter. She originally set up a home in Sydney for young women and organized other homes around New South Wales.
She became a well-known woman and much loved by all the people she helped. Chisholm carried out her work in New South Wales without accepting any money for her work. Chisholm and her husband returned to England in 1846. In those times, Australia's population was around 200,000 people, so if you think that Caroline Chisholm helped over 10,000 people, that is just unbelievable. Then when you consider the families of those people and the generations that followed, you start to see how special Caroline Chisholm was and how big an impact she had in Australia in such a short time.
Today, there are many special places dedicated to her memory, including the cottage she used to provide homes to all these people, as well as having a Catholic college, and today, the Chisholm Institute of TAFE, one of the biggest education providers for Australian names, to continue her legacy by providing access to education to many people at a lower cost. In Chisholm, we like to help people in need and look after anyone who needs support. I am honoured to be in a house named after such a remarkable woman, and you should be too.
Bye!
I think Caroline Chisholm is an
What was the question?
Oh, your finger was in the...
You're going to ask me?
Now time to... What? Yes.
Did you get in trouble?
No.
Oh, thank God. Good job.
Our next item is the house points. Here are the winners for week 7. In 4th place we have Chisholm. Coming in 3rd place last week we have Flynn. In 2nd place is Bradman. So that means our winner for week 7 is Melba. Well done, Melba.
Cause I'm ready to go.
You know what time it is.
Give me the green light. Cause I'm ready to go. Let's have a good time.
Let's go.
What you waiting for? You only got one life.
One life.
And we gon' live it up. So give me the green light. Cause I'm ready to go.
Remember to make good choices and earn house points for your house this week.
Now time for reminders. Please remember to bring a drink bottle to school, as now we are experiencing warmer weather and it is very important to keep hydrated. Make sure that you only touch your bottle when you place it in a tub at recess and lunch. It is also important to be sun smart, wearing a hat and sunscreen. Unfortunately, Mr. DeLay is unavailable today. He will be back next week for his principal report. Now, if it's your birthday today, then happy birthday.
Squeak, squeak. Thanks for joining us again, and we hope you have a great week. Please join the Flynn House Captains next week for another action. Bye.
Bye.
Best ending.
It's action packed. Okay.